I just created a victim.
I wasn't recording.
Just in case you guys know, I want to make sure you guys understand the three levels of penalties.
Oh, good.
The bottom is called forfeiture, and it's named that because you forfeit things, usually money. Like a traffic ticket or something stupid here in the village. Then there's the misdemeanor. That's a low level crime. You know, you steal something less than $2,500, retail theft, punch a dude in the face, whatever. Then there's the felony. That's where we're really creating victims. Those are the serious crimes or the penalties that carry with it that the legislative branch has determined prison time is needed. So we're talking felonies here. You may not believe me, but I got it right here in my hand. So what Susie Q did by taking a photo of herself and sending it to her boyfriend, even though they're dating, even though they're in love, even though she consented to it, she manufactured and she disseminated child pornography, a felony in the state of Wisconsin. And you know, Billy Bob got it, and maybe on his phone, he's now in possession of child pornography, a felony. He then showed it to Steve. He has now disseminated to Steve, another felony. Each photo carries with it its own charge. So if Susie Q sends four photos, that's four counts of possession, dissemination, and child pornography. Felonies in the state of Wisconsin, no questions. No, I'll leave it right here. Possession of child pornography, 948.121M, it says, whoever possesses, whoever, there is no age attached to that, whoever possesses or accesses in any way with the intent to view any undeveloped film, photographic negative, photograph, motion picture, videotape, or other recording of a child, which is anyone under the age of 18, engaged in sexually explicit conduct. And all you can prove is that you looked at it, or you have it, and that you knew that that person was under the age of 18. So Billy Bob's 82, he knows she's 15. That's a given. Makes my case really easy. There's another value we can go after. Exposing a child to harmful material. So even if you show it to somebody, you don't physically give them a copy of that file, that's another felony. So what comes with these felonies? Yeah, even though you guys are juveniles, that don't mean you can't get charged. Prison time, a mark on your juvenile record, you're done with athletics, registered sex offender, jeez, what else? Scholarships out the window. Boy, that university would be really happy to see that on the record. Yeah, I'm going to admit that dude that's got possession of child pornography and that girl that disseminated child pornography. No. You don't want that stigma. So you guys think that it's this... It doesn't count because I'm under 18. No, it does. It does count. It says, whoever, I'll give you a copy of it. You can read it. There's a whole bunch of things I think you guys can do some research on. I think you guys can talk about it. It don't matter if you guys are in a relationship. It don't matter if you're in love. It don't matter. I talked to the district attorney before I came up here last week. He just, it is black and white in the law. If you got it, you're going to be charged. Hands are tied. It's a sex crime involving a child. Well, you just start sweeping under the rug. I don't think so. You know, back to third order effects. And that gets touched too. You know, girls start getting in this, not to be sad, it happens with boys too. That's how kids kill. That's how kids kill themselves. It starts off so innocent. I'm sharing something with my girlfriend, or I'm sharing something with my boyfriend. And then they break up like most high school relationships, and that photo goes wild. Now you walk through the hallway knowing that everybody is seeing you naked. That's what kids kill themselves. And I don't mean to be blunt with it, but that's what it is. You need to be able to wake up in the morning and think, that that was happening to my kid, I would want the cops to do everything in their power to put that to bed. Squash it. And, you know, what if it's your sister? What if you know, somebody comes up there and got to enforce your sister? You're gonna be irate. We can make it even more personal. What if it's a naked picture of your mom? You want to make a picture of your mother floating on a light pole? I'm serious. Tone it down. Think about it, though. You want to make it personal? We can make it personal. Start putting this in your back pocket, thinking that. These are genuine victims here. This is no joke. And I don't think you ruin your life. You can ruin other people's lives. It's very upsetting. I said I'm giving this speech as an informational thing only. I said I'm not going to follow you out here and start doing an investigation and charging you all. That's your question. We can talk later if you wish. Well, if you got a question, I'll answer. I'm not scared. What's that? What are you talking about? You know what, we'll talk later. Okay, we'll finish this up, because obviously it's divulging to something that someone doesn't know what they're doing. But you guys need to start looking out for each other instead of using each other. Thank you for your research.